Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you retarded potential. See, retarded potential that we measure in time varying field. So first of all, you need to understand how many types of potentials are there. See, there are two types of potentials in EM waves. One is vector magnetic potential and second is scalar electric potential. First of all, I'll explain you how to identify vector magnetic potential and scalar electric potential. To understand that, you need to understand this diagram first. See, here we have conductor. And with this conductor, let us assume current I is flowing through this conductor in this direction. To calculate vector magnetic potential and scalar electric potential, here I'll be considering small volume over here. And because of this small volume, we will be calculating vector magnetic potential and scalar magnetic potential. For that calculation, here we have origin, and with respect to origin, this small volume is there at vector r dash. Here we have observation point. At this point, we will be calculating vector magnetic potential and scalar electric potential, and that is apported by vector small r over here. And this observation point that is there at capital vector R with respect to small volume over here. Now, because of current I, there are few quantities that you need to understand. See, here we have current I. And because of current I, you will be observing with this small volume, we will be having current density. And current density is denoted by J. Here, because of current I, in this small volume, you will be observing, we will be having volume charge density. And this volume charge density is rho V. Now, see, I'll explain you how we can identify vector magnetic potential first. See, vector magnetic potential that happens because of magnetic field. So first of all, you need to understand how direction of magnetic field will be there. See, here we have considered this current I that is happening in this direction. As it is happening in this direction, as per right hand thumb rule, you will be observing there will be direction of magnetic field that will be happening as per this direction, right? It will be happening as per this direction. So here you will be observing at this observation point vector magnetic potential that will be inside to the page, and that we can calculate as per A, and it is having direction. See, vector magnetic potential will be having direction, and that one can calculate as per mu by 4 pi integration of J divided by R with respect to volume. So here vector magnetic potential that one can calculate based on mu by 4 pi integration of J with respect to volume integration divided by R, where this R that is distance of observation point with respect to this source section, right? And it is having direction. Now I'll explain you scalar electric potential. See, scalar electric potential is happening because of electric field. And it is not having direction, it is scalar quantity. So electric field that will be happening because of this current I. As if current is flowing in this direction, then electric field that will be happening as per this direction, you see it will be outward to the conductor over here. So if you want to see that, then it will be outward to the conductor. You can observe, it will be outward to the conductor. Right, as if you want to measure this scalar electric potential because of this electric field, then at this observation point, it will be denoted by V, that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into volume integration of rho V divided by R. See, volume integration of rho V, that is charge Q. So you can say V is equals to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R, but here we need to identify that with respect to volume charge density which is happening in this small differential section, right? So scalar electric potential that can be calculated as per this equation. Now we need to understand how these potentials are changing with respect to time. The reason is, in antenna we apply time varying field, right? So here this current I that will be changing with respect to time. So as if magnitude of current that is increasing, then but obviously magnetic field will increase as well as this electric field that will increase. But here there are few things that you need to understand. Like, you see, as if current is happening in this direction, as if current I is happening in this direction, then you will be observing that this magnetic field that will be happening in this direction, right? It will be happening in this direction, and you will be observing electric field that will be outward to the conductor direction. And as if I say current I that is flowing in opposite direction, let us say it is flowing in this direction, so in that case you will be observing this electric field now that will be inward to the conductor. It will be now inward to the conductor, you can observe. And this magnetic field that will be changing as per the direction that you can observe, that is opposite to the direction of this, right? So here electric field and magnetic field both are changing with its direction as well as with its magnitude in time varying field, right? So direction and magnitude is changing with respect to time in time varying field. And that's why in time varying field we calculate retarded potential. To calculate retarded potential, in these two equations of potential there are few changes that is required. Let me explain first what are those changes. See, here in above discussion there is a finite propagation time t dash that is required for wave to travel at certain distance r, and that time will be how much? That time will be distance divided by velocity, where distance is capital R and velocity is velocity of EM wave. So here you see we have observation point over here that is there at distance R from the source. So here, as and when some changes is happening in this small volume at that time, here to have a change at this point some time is required, that is delay time. And that delay time is how much? That delay time is this distance r divided by velocity, right? So always there will be some propagation time, that is r by c, that is delay time, right? So here you will be observing for a calculation of vector magnetic potential A at distance r at time t due to j, you will be observing some delay is happening. So you don't place time t over here, instead of that you will have to place time t minus r by c. And scalar potential v at distance r at time t will be happening due to rho v, where time is not t over here, it will be t minus r by c, where r by c is that delay because of propagation, right? So I have explained you two equations. See, one equation is of vector magnetic potential that I have explained, that is mu by 4 pi integration of j by r with respect to volume integration, and scalar electric potential that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon integration of rho v by r with respect to volume integration, where see this j and rho v both are changing with respect to time, and that is changing with respect to time along with delay, right? So you can rewrite this equation as per, you see, this vector magnetic potential will be mu by 4 pi, where instead of j you can say this j is changing with respect to location r as well as it is changing with respect to time, Not only that, along with that, you need to place delay as well. So T minus R by C. So J is a function of R, time, and this delay R by C, right? Divided by capital R with respect to volume dV. And this scalar electric potential, that is a function of rho V. Now that equation will be changing as per, you see, it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon integration, where rho V is function of R, it is function of time, and it is also function of delay. So here T minus R by C that you need to have, divided by capital R, integration is there with respect to volume, right? So here, see, in this two expression, we have a delay of R by C. So now we can say above potentials are having some delay. That's why it is delayed potential, or you can say it is retarded potential because of some time delay, right? So that is how retarded potential concept that is coming into the picture, that is happening because of some delay in source element, right? See, here we will be measuring those potentials, and see, instant change will happen at this source where we have considered small differential volume, but potential change will appear over here after some delay. So but obviously, see, here potential will be changing with respect to location, with respect to time, as well as with respect to delay. That's why whatever entities that we measure over here, that will be having some delay. That's why it is referred as delayed potential, or one can say retarded potentials. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.